Suspense. Your host is Autolite, maker of the sensational Autolite resistor spark plug and the Autolite Stay Full battery. Autolite makes over 400 products for cars and trucks, bumpers and hubcaps, radiator grills and ornaments, bullseye seal beam headlights, ignition systems, spark plugs, batteries, fuel pumps, windshield wipers, instruments and gauges, wire and battery cable, and many more. So remember, from bumper to tail light, you're always right with Autolite. And now, Autolite and its 96,000 dealers everywhere present Suspense.
Okay, Marty, it's 75 cents.
Man, that's a real gone platter.
Marty! Joe!
Eat it, dog!
Oh, you're cool.
Eat it, love!
Take it, baby, man. Ooh, my great.
Guess where I was, Marty? Guess, guess! Down to Box City in that dog kid.
Oh, man, is he crazy? He nearly killed me.
Oh, that van is real crazy. I'm going down there now and talk to Bob.
Now you're with me.
Hey, wait a minute.
Change.
Ah. Geeky later, Smarty Marty.
You know, I still can't figure out what you guys are saying.
Oh, it's easier once you get that rhythm.
I think I'll take a walk down the street and get my hair cut. The booth is still open.
Okay, Mr. Brockman. Say, I've been thinking, Mr. Brockman. Did you really mean what you said the other day about the shop?
Why, yes. Yes, indeed, I did, Fred. Yes, indeed. I feel sure that this work is going to be too hard for me soon, and you're just the boy to carry on.
Well, I haven't got much saved yet, Mr. Brockman, but if you'll let me sign a note, I'll pay it just as soon as I can.
Well, now, we won't worry about that. I'm sure that we'll be able to figure out something, Fred. Now, you're a good boy, Freddy, a good boy.
May I help you?
How do you do?
Classical, isn't it?
I beg your pardon?
It's a game I play, trying to guess the kind of music a customer wants before he tells me. You see, we call ourselves the Bebop Alley, but we've got classics here, too. Mozart, Bach, Beethoven.
I see, you're quite correct in the way I am very fond of all those composers, but I don't want any records just now. Oh, that is, well, I do in a way, but what I wanted to ask you now is this your place?
No, this place belongs to Mr. Brockman. I just work here.
Oh.
I didn't want us to sell him, though. Mr. Brockman, he's really the boss, but he sort of takes it easy.
I see. Is he away for the night?
No, he's just gone out to get a haircut.
I see. Well, you probably know all the stock here pretty well, don't you?
Oh, sure. I don't mind saying there's probably not a record here that I don't know about or just exactly where to put my hands on it. So if there's anything you want, anything special, that is, like a collector's item or anything, you just let me know. You don't have to wait for Mr. Brockman.
How late do you work?
Well, I don't have any regular hours. I guess I could get off whenever I wanted to.
You've got to help me.
What do you mean?
Could you use some money?
Sure. Anybody can always use money, but...
Do you know the Griffin Hotel?
I've heard of it. It's on the other side of town, isn't it?
Here's the address and room number. Come see me there as soon as your boss comes back and you can get away.
Look, mister, I don't take money unless I know what it's for, so take it back, will you?
Oh, Freddy. That music in the street again, it's loud enough to wake the dead.
Hello, Mrs. Broder.
Oh, look, Freddy, I can't stand it anymore. Can't you at least turn down the volume?
Yes, I will, Mrs. Broder.
Well, do it now, won't you? Why do I have to ask you the same thing night after night?
Well, the control button's in the booth there, and I don't want to disturb the customer.
Disturb the customer? Well, what about me? Don't I get disturbed? Gee, I was sitting upstairs in my room there all alone in this heat, and I was shaking. Look at me. I'm still shaking.
I know, Mrs. Barber, but look, it's only 8 o'clock.
I know what time it is, Freddy, but my nerves don't work by a clock. Gee whiz, I paid good money for that room upstairs. I'm certainly entitled to at least a little bit of peace.
Of course you are, Mrs. Barber, but you know that
I
we've got...
I know. Don't tell me you've got a license. Yeah, a license to drive me crazy until 10 o'clock every night. Now, look, Freddy, I'm going to tell you something. If that noise don't shut down by 10 sharp tonight, you're going to hear from me. Now, this time, I'm really going to do something about it. Now, I mean it. Remember, this is my last warning.
Bebop.
Thought I'd pick up these while I was here.
Okay. You like bebop?
No, something new. I'm always interested in new types of music, even if I don't always like them. Here. Take it out of this. It's all right, isn't it? You will come tonight, won't you?
I don't know, mister.
You've got to help me. It's desperately important. You've got to help me. Promise you'll come. Griffin Hotel, room 317. I need your help. I'll be expecting you as soon as you can get away. And don't say a word to anybody. Please.
Excuse me.
Hey, Joe, turn down that volume, will you? Hey, mister. Mister.
Ready, boy. Wait a minute.
I won't latch onto this now. Fuck it. Now, look, here's the bit. I'm going to cut out, but I'll be back later. Maybe you can go out and brew up.
Okay.
You with me, man?
Yeah.
I'll dig you later.
Pete had too many people waiting down there, and I didn't get my hair cut.
Oh, that's too bad, Mr. Brockman.
No, one day more or less don't matter. It'll just grow 1/32nd of an inch longer. I'm lucky to have any left at all. What's the matter? Something worrying you?
Mr. Brockman, you're a man of experience. If a stranger asks you for help, do you think you ought to help him?
Well, that depends on the person himself, Freddy.
Well, will you be needing me for a while?
No, but it's past your quitting time anyway, isn't it?
Yes, but I'll be back. I told Joe I'd go out and get a couple of beers.
I think you ought to get some sleep. I'll tell Joe to wait if he comes back.
Okay, thanks.
Now, take care of yourself, Freddy. Be careful.
I will, Mr. Brockman. Good night.
Good night.
Evening. Hi. Hey! Where are you going?
317.
Mr. Evans?
Yes, Mr. Evans.
Come here. He expecting you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Say, what's he like?
Why don't you ask him?
Is that my key?
You sure may.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night.
Is Mr. Evans in there?
What do you want?
Mr. Evans is expecting me. Is he in there? I'm from the music store.
No. Who told you to come?
Mr. Evans did. He said it was important.
Yeah? What do you want you for?
He said he wanted to talk to me.
What do you say about the store?
What about the store?
The music store. Brockman's Bebop Alley.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Come on in.
Marty!
Hi, kid.
What are you doing here? What is this, a party?
Yeah, a party.
Come on in, baby. It's cold outside. You have a little drink with me. My name's Millie.
I guess you thought I was barging in. He didn't say anything about a party.
Who?
Mr. Evans. Where is he?
Oh, he's out.
Oh, I guess maybe I better come back.
Oh, no. You've got to have a drink with me. Marty, fix the kid a drink. He needs a drink. I need a drink, too. What's your name?
Fred.
Hello? Just a minute.
Oh, I like the name of Freddy. Freddy and Millie. Freddy and Millie are gonna dance. Freddy, did you say you had a music store?
Uh-huh.
Oh, I think that's wonderful. There's nothing I like better than lots of new records.
Here's some drinks.
Oh, thanks, lover.
Marty, this is his room, isn't it?
Sure, it's his room. What's your business with him?
Well, nothing special except he gave me some money and... Well, I guess maybe I don't have to see him now. I mean, not tonight. I guess I'd better go.
Hey, no, we can't let a fella go with only one drink.
No, I don't want any...
Oh, sure you do. You got to drink with Millie because Millie doesn't like to drink alone.
No, I don't... Mr. Evans, you said he was...
I said he was out there. Sounds like a lie. Poor Mr. Evans. He had too much to drink and he couldn't take it. Oh, where's my drink, Marty?
No. I want to talk to Mr. Evans.
But you can. He's passed out. Come on, let's dance.
Yeah.
Oh, look out, you big
dog. I'm sorry. Making
it. Oh, you poor cold.
That's all right. I'd better go.
What did Mr. Evans want you for, kid?
He said he wanted to tell me something.
Yeah? What about?
Didn't say. Just said it was important.
Uh-huh. What else he say?
Just said he wanted to talk to me. Marty, did you know?
So you come here just like that, huh? He wants to ask you a question, so you come here.
Well, he gave me some money. That's why I came. What is all this, anyway? How did he get drunk so fast? He wasn't drunk when I saw him. Marty? Mr. Evans. He's not drunk. He's
down.
He's out of it.
Yeah.
Get out. Get out.
What did you do to him?
Maybe we'll find out. Now, maybe you'll talk now. What do you say, Mr. Evans? You wanted to tell this kid something. What did you want to tell him? Go on, kid, ask him. He won't talk to us.
Oh, do you have to break the kid's arm?
Ask him what he wanted to tell you.
33 drums. Three collectors drums.
What's he talking about?
He's out again.
What'd he say, Tony?
Enough.
We'll see the second act of this suspense story, Collector's Item. Yes, this is the day when everyone starts thinking about school days again. So during this brief intermission, I'd like to tell you a short story about an absent-minded professor and a lesson he learned. Now, it seems that our professor was in a great hurry to get to his first class of the new term. But our absent-minded friend had forgotten something. He'd forgotten to have water put in his battery. So the battery went dead, and the car wouldn't start. Well, now, if our professor had asked me, I could have told him that extreme loss of water is one of the principal causes of battery failure. And I also could have told him that if he had a new, dependable Autolite stay-full battery, he'd have to remember to give it water only 3 times a year in normal car use. Now, friends, let me tell you why it works out like that. You see, in the ordinary battery, small particles keep flaking off the positive plates. So the ordinary battery has to have a large space in the bottom of the case to hold those particles. Otherwise, they'll get together and short-circuit the cells. But there's a big difference in the new Autolite stay-full battery. In the stay-full battery, every positive plate has a fiberglass retaining mat protecting it, holding the active materials in place. Now there you see the fiberglass, the feature that gives a real advantage to the Autolite stay-full battery. Whereas the ordinary battery requires this much extra space below the plates, the Autolite stay-full doesn't need all that space. So we can take the extra space and use it to advantage by putting it up above the plates. Now if we pour electrolyte in both batteries, enough in each one to cover the plates completely, there's space left for extra water. But you see, an ordinary battery holds only this much extra water, whereas the Autolite stay-full battery with that additional space above the plates holds over 3 times as much water. That gives over 3 times the liquid protection of ordinary batteries. And that's why you have to add water to your Autolite stay-full battery only 3 times a year in normal car use. And say, here's another fact that you drivers should know about. In recent tests conducted according to the life cycle standards of the Society of Automotive Engineers, the Autolite stay-full battery was found to give over 70% longer average life than batteries without the stay-full features. So you can see, it's really wise to buy an Autolite stay-full, the battery that you only need to give water 3 times a year in normal car use. Well, to finish up my little story, was our friend the professor happy with his Autolite stay-full battery? I'll say he was, because now he won't have any trouble starting his car and... Oh, say, Professor, do you realize you've forgotten something? You forgot your pants. And now, here is the second act of Collector's Item.
Mr. Evans.
Back to help you. Freddie, you're in an awful jam.
Mr. Evans is...
He's dead. And you'll be too if you don't get out of here.
I better call the police.
The police? Are you crazy? Look at yourself. Look at this room. They pin it on you.
But I didn't do it.
Of course you didn't. That's why they roughed you up like this. They poured whiskey all over you. They're trying to frame you.
Where'd they go?
They beat it. And you'd better beat it too.
I wish I could think. I wish I could figure it out.
Freddie, I'm telling you. They tipped the clerk to call the cops. Now, come on.
Leave me alone.
Freddie.
I'm sick.
Oh.
I get this telephone call, see? And somebody tells me I better go look upstairs. I don't even know who it is.
Where?
Upstairs. Well, room 317. Name of Evans. Well, I go up. I figure somebody may be playing a joke, and on the other hand, they may not be. The door ain't locked, see? So, well, I knock. Nobody answers. I push it open. And... what a mess.
Come on up, Joe.
Come on, kid. Come on, kid. Try to sit up now, will you? Come on. Pull yourself together, will you? Oh, wait. I'll get you something. Here. Come on now, kid. Take Mama's word for it. You gotta get out of here.
What did they hit me for? Why did they do that to Mr. Evans?
Freddie, take my word for it. You're on an awful spot. They made you the fall guy. You got no time to ask questions.
Why did you come back?
Come on, Freddie. You gotta get out of here. I'm doing you a big favor, kid.
I don't want your big favors.
Freddie! Oh. Freddie.
The police. Oh, what are we gonna do?
I know a better way.
Why are you doing this for me?
I don't know. Maybe it's because I like bebop.
Who are you, Millie?
Me? Nobody. I just happened to be going around with some of them.
You were there in that room with them.
I said I'd play along with them. But this business tonight with Evans, I never expected that. I never got mixed up in anything like that before, and I don't like it. I don't like it. Rye, make his a double. I don't like what they were trying to do to you either. Framing a kid like you.
Why did they do it? Why did they torture Evans?
Maybe they were trying to find out something.
What?
I don't know. I figure maybe he had something on them. Maybe they were trying to find out what he knew.
Is that Tony, the boss?
Tony? That mug? He takes orders.
If I could just figure this thing out. Who was Evans? What did he know?
I don't know. You better start thinking about yourself. You can't stay here. As soon as Tony finds out you got away, he'll be looking for you just like the cops. He'll be looking for me, too.
Evans kept repeating something about drums and collectors and...
What was all that?
I don't know. Unless
Maybe it had something to do with records. Collector's items. It must have had something to do with the store.
What's the matter?
My wallet's gone. I must have left it up in that room there.
Hey, you can't go back there.
No, I guess not. I better get back to the record store.
Why?
Because I think I know now what Evans was trying to tell me. You wait here.
I can't. Hurry, I'll be looking for
you. I won't be long enough. Please wait for me.
Be careful.
Okay.
Oh, what did I let myself in for?
Yeah. I don't know how I got out. It was as sweet a frame as you could ask for, but he got out of it. Yeah, I tried to find out, but I couldn't guess how much. Yeah, Marty's on his way right there now. Yeah, okay, I'll be along. Yeah, I'll be right there.
You know, Mr. Brockman, I always used to tell my husband, may his soul rest in peace, that companionship is the happiest aspect of marriage.
You're so right, Mrs. Brockman.
Oh, I hope I'm not keeping you from your work or anything. I wouldn't want to interrupt your work.
No, it's not closing time anyway.
Oh, goodness, I didn't realize it was that late.
Mr. Brockman, I've got to talk to you.
Oh, now, Freddie, you're very rude.
I'm sorry, but there's something I have to tell you.
I'm sure it can wait until Mrs. Broder and I finish talking.
Oh, I can leave.
Oh, no, I wouldn't think of it, Mrs. Broder.
Well, I did want to ask, I hope you won't misinterpret this, but I was wondering whether you'd like to come upstairs later for a little light refreshment. You know, potato salad and glass of beer. I never eat any of that Lord Dunsany. Okay. You know, I always make a roast beef over the weekend,
Mr. Brockman. What did he want?
Who? Marty?
Yes.
Oh, he came to ask if my last Gillespie shipment had come in yet. Why?
Because earlier tonight.
I think you owe Mrs. Broder an apology. I thought you had better manners than to interrupt the conversation.
Oh, never mind. I was on my way anyway. I'll see you upstairs later then.
Well, I should be delighted, and thank you so much.
Till later then.
Until later.
I didn't mean to be rude, Mr. Brockman, but I'm in terrible danger, and Marty is part of it.
Marty? Why, he's your friend.
He and some other men tried to frame me for murder. They've got the police after
me. Police? Fred, why should the police be after you? Freddie, you've been drinking.
No, I was, Mr. Brockman, but I'm all right now.
No, Fred, I've got to close the store. You just sit down and you'll be feeling better. This is no time to be playing records. Shut off that machine now.
Mr. Brockman, I'm afraid we're in terrible danger. Mr. Evans was killed, and Marty was part of it. They tortured him, and then when I came into the room, they made it seem like a party until I saw what it really was. And before he died, Mr. Evans kept talking about drums. Something about drums and collector's items, and I'm sure he must have meant these records, these collector's items. Your records, Mr. Brockman. There's something in your records that made a man die tonight. Them.
Ready? Answer the door.
No.
You'd better answer it. Go answer it.
You call the police. I don't care what happens to me now, but you've got to protect yourself.
I'll be able to take care of myself. Now you just open the door, Fred. I'll stay in the back.
All right.
Freddie, I couldn't wait. I had to come. You gotta get out of here.
Billy, I've gotta take the chance. I'm so close now. I've got the records. I'm sure they're the right records.
Well, take them and go.
I can't. If I could only remember what else he said.
Well, Freddie, can't you play them someplace else?
Where?
I don't know. Any place.
No, come on in the booth. It won't take a minute.
They'll be here any minute. It's almost 11:30.
30. That's it. 33.
Are you wacky?
Drums. Evans said drums. This whole series is called Drums. And then he said 3-3. He must have meant 33. 33 revolutions per minute. Now, all these records are 78 RPM, and that's the way that I've been playing them. Listen. You see? They sound just like ordinary bebop. But now, if I try them at 33...
You're a very smart boy, Freddie.
Fred! He's one of them. He came to see them this week.
Mr. Brockman, he's my boss.
It was very foolish of you to come here, young lady. And as for you, Fred, I didn't expect you back at all. As a matter of fact, you should be in the hands of the police now, accused of the murder of Evans.
You knew about Evans?
Why, of course. He was a government agent. He found out a few things, and he was snooping around trying to find out more.
Freddy, he's the one that gave the orders.
The young lady is quite right.
You had him tortured.
Well, we had to find out what he knew. Poor little Freddy. Why, if you'd minded your own business, nothing would have happened to you. The others will be here soon, and by tomorrow morning we will all be gone. Everything. Everyone. And then there will be nothing left but a deserted record shop.
That record? What is it?
It's one of a set of a series for Brockman's Bebop Alley. Freddy, play it at 33.
+10.
You know what that is?
4.
It is a key. A key to the military code of this country. A simple bebop record that can be shipped all over the world without suspicion. Now, Fred, play it at 78.
Oh, why won't you let us go? We don't know anything about this. We're not even interested. Just let us go and you'll never hear from us again.
You won't have long to wait. The others will be here soon.
That music.
Stop him, officer. He's the one who turned on those records.
All right, come on, kid.
Yes, it's disturbing.
Officer, you've got to arrest that man. You've got to arrest him, officer.
Just one moment, officer, if you please. I think I am at fault in this. You see, I am the owner of this store. And accidentally, I touched the switch on the wall that amplified the music to the street.
Look, mister, this lady made a complaint, and there's an ordinance against this kind of thing. You can't make a racket like that at this hour.
Mrs. Broder, if you will only forgive me just this once, I can assure you it will never happen again.
No. Officer, you've got to arrest this man. He's a murderer and he's a spy. There's a code on this record.
The kid's right. Oh, it's the Griffin
Nonsense.
Hotel case.
Nonsense, is it? Look.
It's the Griffin Hotel case. He's in back of it. We're all mixed up in it but her.
Well, maybe you're all involved in this. I think I'll take the whole lot of you in. Come on, get moving.
This is Rex Marshall speaking for Autolite, and in just a moment I'll tell you about our story for next week. But first, let's see if you can identify one of Hollywood's leading actresses, Miss Irene Dunne, star of the RKO picture, I Remember Mama. Now, looking at this photo, would you say that this is Irene Dunne or her look-alike, Kay Smith of Porchester, New York? Now, here's the other photo. Is this Kay Smith or is this really Irene Dunne? Well, comparing the two side by side, perhaps you've guessed that the first picture we showed you, the one now on the left, is Irene Dunne, and the girl on the right is Miss Smith. Well, you know, friends, batteries may look alike, too, but there's only one Autolite Stayful. The Autolite Stayful is the battery that needs water only 3 times a year in normal car use. And, in addition, in tests conducted by SAE Life Cycle Standards, the Autolite Stayful battery gives 70% longer average life than batteries without the Stayful feature. And remember, too, that the Stayful is the battery that you need to add water to only 3 times a year in normal car use. So wise motorists, remember that money can't buy a better battery. And remember, too, from bumper to tail light, you're always right with Autolite. Our suspense story will be Robert Louis Stevenson's Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde.
This is CBS, the Columbia Broadcasting System.
If I could just figure this thing out, who was Evans? What did he know?
I don't know. You better start thinking about yourself. You can't stay here. As soon as Tony finds out you got away, he'll be looking for you just like the cops. Looking for me, too.
Evans kept repeating something about drums and collectors and...
What was all that?
I don't know. Unless maybe it had something to do with records. Collector's items.
It must have had something to do with the store.
What's the matter?
My wallet's gone. I must have left it up in that room there.
Hey, you can't go back there.
No, I guess not. I better get back to the record store.
Why?
Because I think I know now what Evans was trying to tell me. You wait here.
I can't. Come here, be looking for
me. I won't be long enough. Please wait for me.
Be careful.
Okay.
Oh, what did I let myself in for?
Yeah. I don't know how I got out. It was as sweet a frame as you could ask for, but he got out of it. Yeah, I tried to find out, but I couldn't guess how much. Yeah, Marty's on his way right there now. Yeah, okay, I'll be along. Yeah, I'll be right there.
You know, Mr. Brockman, I always used to tell my husband, may his soul rest in peace, that companionship is the happiest aspect of marriage.
You are so right, Mrs. Brockman.
Oh, I hope I'm not keeping you from your work or anything. I wouldn't want to interrupt your work.
No, it's not closing time anyway.
Mr. Brockman, I've got to talk to you.
Oh, now, Freddie, you're very rude.
I'm sorry, but there's something I have to tell you.
I'm sure it can wait until Mrs. Broder and I finish talking.
Oh, I can leave.
Oh, no, I wouldn't think of it, Mrs. Broder.
Well, I did want to ask, I hope you won't misinterpret this, but I was wondering whether you'd like to come upstairs later for a little light refreshment, you know, potato salad, and glass of beer, and cold cut time. Maybe more myself. I never eat any of that Lord Dunsany. You know, I always make a roast beef over the weekend, Mr.
Brockman, what did he want?
Who? Marty?
Yes.
Oh, he came to ask if my last Gillespie shipment had come in yet. Why?
Because earlier tonight...
I think you owe Mrs. Broder an apology. I thought you had better manners than to interrupt the conversation.
Oh, never mind. I was on my way anyway. I'll see you upstairs later then.
Well, I should be delighted, and thank you so much.
Till later then.
Until later.
I didn't mean to be rude, Mr. Brockman, but I'm in terrible danger, and Marty is part of it.
Marty? Why, he's your friend.
He and some other men...
According to the life cycle standards of the Society of Automotive Engineers, the Autolite Stay Full battery was found to give over 70% longer average life than batteries without the Stay Full features. So you can see, it's really wise to buy an Autolite Stay Full, the battery that you only need to give water 3 times a year in normal car use. Well, to finish up my little story, was our friend the professor happy with his Autolite Stay Full battery? I'll say he was, because now he won't have any trouble starting his car and... Uh-oh. Say, Professor, do you realize you've forgotten something? You forgot your pants. And now, here is the second act of Collector's Item.
What are you here for?
I came back to help you. Freddy, you're in an awful jam.
Mr. Evans is...
He's dead. And you'll be too if you don't get out of here.
I better call the police.
The police? Are you crazy? Look at yourself. Look at this room. They pin it on you.
But I didn't do it.
Of course you didn't. That's why they roughed you up like this. They poured whiskey all over you. They're trying to frame you.
Where'd they go?
They beat it. And you'd better beat it too.
I wish I could think. I wish I could figure it out.
Oh, Freddie, I'm telling you. They tipped the clerk to call the cops. Now, come on.
Leave me alone.
Freddie.
I'm sick.
Oh.
I get this telephone call, see? And somebody tells me I better go look upstairs. I don't even know who it is.
Where?
Upstairs. Or room 317. Name of Evans. When I go up, I figure somebody may be playing a joke, and on the other hand, they may not be. The door ain't locked, see? So, well, I knock. Nobody answers. I push it open, and what a mess.
Come on up, Joe.
Oh, don't tell me you got a license. Yeah, a license to drive me crazy till 10 o'clock every night. Now, look, Freddy, I'm going to tell you something. If that noise don't shut down by 10 sharp tonight, you're going to hear from me. Now, this time, I'm really going to do something about it. Now, I mean it. Now, remember, this is my last warning.
Thought I'd pick up these while I was here.
Okay. You like bebop?
No, something new. I'm always interested in new types of music, even if I don't always like them. Here. Take it out of this. It's all right, isn't it? You will come tonight, won't you?
I don't know, mister.
You've got to help me. It's desperately important. You've got to help me. Promise you'll come. Griffin Hotel, room 317. I need your help. I'll be expecting you as soon as you can get away. And don't say a word to anybody. Please.
Excuse me.
Hey, Joe, turn down that volume, will you? Hey, mister. Mister.
Ready, boy, wait.
I won't latch onto this now. Fuck it. Now, look, here's the bit. I'm going to cut out, but I'll be back later. Maybe you can go out and brew up.
Okay.
You with me, man?
Yeah.
I'll dig you later.
Pete had too many people waiting down there, and I didn't get my haircut.
Oh, that's too bad, Mr. Brockman.
No, one day more or less don't matter. That'll just go 1/32nd of an inch longer. I'm lucky to have any left at all. What's the matter? Something worrying you?
Mr. Brockman, you're a man of experience. If a stranger asks you for help, do you think you ought to help him?
Well, that depends on the person himself, Freddy.
Well, will you be needing me for a while?
No, but it's past your quitting time anyway, isn't it?
Yes, but I'll be back. I told Joe I'd go out and get a couple of beers.
I think you ought to get some sleep. I'll tell Joe to wait if he comes back.
Okay, thanks.
Now, take care of yourself, Freddy. Be careful.
I will, Mr. Brockman. Good night.
Good night.
Evening. Hi. Hey! Where are you going?
317.
Mr. Evans?
Yes, Mr. Evans.
Come here. He expecting you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Say, what's he like?
Why don't you ask him?
Can I have my key?
You sure may.
Thank you, good night.
Good night.
Oh, Freddy. That music in the street again, it's loud enough to wake the dead.
Hello, Mrs. Broder.
Oh, look, Freddy, I can't stand it anymore. Can't you at least turn down the volume?
Yes, I will, Mrs. Broder.
Well, do it now, won't you? Why do I have to ask you the same thing night after night?
Well, the control button's in the booth there, and I don't want to disturb the customer.
Disturb the customer? Well, what about me? Don't I get disturbed? Gee, I was sitting upstairs in my room there all alone in this heat, and I was shaking. Look at me. I'm still shaking.
I know, Mrs. Barber. Look, it's only 8 o'clock.
I know what time it is, Freddy, but my nerves don't work by a clock. Gee whiz, I paid good money for that room upstairs. I'm certainly entitled to at least a little bit of peace.
Of course you are, Mrs. Barber, but you know that
I
we've
I know. Don't tell me you've got a license. Yeah, a license to drive me crazy until 10 o'clock every night. Now, look, Freddy, I'm going to tell you something. If that noise don't shut down by 10 sharp tonight, you're going to hear from me. Now, this time, I'm really going to do something about it. Now, I mean it. Now, remember, this is my last warning.
Thought I'd pick up these while I was here.
Okay. You like bebop?
No, something new. I'm always interested in new types of music, even if I don't always like them. Here. Take it out of this. It's all right, isn't it? You will come tonight, won't you?
I don't know, mister.
You've got to help me. It's desperately important. You've got to help me. Promise you'll come. Griffin Hotel, room 317. I need your help. I'll be expecting you as soon as you can get away. And don't say a word to anybody. Please.
Excuse me.
Hey, Joe, turn down that volume, will you? Hey, mister. Mister.
Ready, boy, wait.
I won't latch onto this now. Fuck it. Now, look, here's the bit. I'm going to cut out, but I'll be back later. Maybe you can go out and brew up.
Okay.
You with me, man?
Yeah.
I'll take you later.
Pete had too many people waiting down there, and I didn't get my haircut.
Oh, that's too bad, Mr. Brockman.
No, one day more or less don't matter. That'll just go 1/32nd of an inch longer. I'm lucky to have any left at all. What's the matter? Something worrying you?
Mr. Brockman, you're a man of experience. If a stranger asks you for help, do you think you ought to help him?
Well, that depends on the person himself, Freddy.
Well, will you be needing me for a while?
No, but it's past your quitting time anyway, isn't it?
Yes, but I'll be back. I told Joe I'd go out and get a couple of beers.
I think you ought to get some sleep. I'll tell Joe to wait if he comes back.
Okay, thanks.
Now, take care of yourself, Freddy. Be careful.
I will, Mr. Brockman. Good night.
Good night.
Evening. Hi. Hey! Where are you going?
317.
Mr. Evans?
Hey, Rodman, did you really mean what you said the other day about the shop?
Why, yes. Yes, indeed, I did, Fred. Yes, indeed. I feel sure that this work is going to be too hard for me soon, and you're just the boy to carry on.
Well, I haven't got much saved yet, Mr. Rodman, but if you let me sign a note, I'll pay you just as soon as I can.
Well, now, we won't worry about that. I'm sure that we'll be able to figure out something, Fred. Now, you're a good boy, Freddy, a good boy.
May I help you?
How do you do?
Classical, isn't it?
I beg your pardon?
It's a game I play, trying to guess the kind of music a customer wants before he tells me. You see, we call ourselves the Bebop Alley, but we've got classics here, too. Mozart, Bach, Beethoven.
I see, you're quite correct in a way. I am very fond of all those composers, but I don't want any records just now. Oh, that is, well, I do in a way, but what I wanted to ask you now is this your place?
No, this place belongs to Mr. Brockman. I just work here.
Oh.
I do most of the selling, though. Mr. Brockman, he's really the boss, but he sort of takes it easy.
I see. Is he away for the night?
No, he's just gone out to get a haircut.
I see. Well, you probably know all the stock here pretty well, don't you?
Oh, sure. I don't mind saying there's probably not a record here that I don't know about or just exactly where to put my hands on it. So if there's anything you want, anything special, that is, like a collector's item or anything, you just let me know. You don't have to wait for Mr. Brockman.
How late do you work?
Well, I don't have any regular hours. I guess I could get off whenever I wanted to.
You've got to help me.
What do you mean?
Could you use some money?
Sure. Anybody can always use money, but...
Do you know the Griffin Hotel?
I've heard of it. It's on the other side of town, isn't it?
Here's the address and room number. Come see me there as soon as your boss comes back and you can get away.
Look, mister, I don't take money unless I know what it's for, so take it back, will you?
Oh, Freddy. That music in the street again, it's loud enough to wake the dead.
Hello, Mrs. Broder.
Oh, look, Freddy, I can't stand it anymore. Can't you at least turn down the volume?
Yes, I will, Mrs.
Broder. Well, do it now, won't you? Why do I have to ask you the same thing night after night?
Well, the control button's in the booth there, and I don't want to disturb the customer.
Disturb the customer? Well, what about me? Don't I get disturbed? Gee, I was sitting upstairs in my room there all alone in this heat, and I was shaking. Look at me. I'm still shaking.
I know, Mrs. Barber. Look, it's only 8 o'clock.
I know what time it is, Freddy, but my nerves don't work by a clock. Gee whiz, I paid good money for that room upstairs. I'm certainly entitled to at least a little bit of peace.
Of course you are, Mrs. Barber, but you know that
I
we've
know.
Got...
Don't tell me you've got a license. Yeah, a license to drive me crazy until 10 o'clock every night. Now, look, Freddy, I'm going to tell you something. If that noise don't shut down by 10 sharp tonight, you're going to hear from me. Now, this time, I'm really going to do something about it. Now, I mean it. Now, remember, this is my last warning.
Thought I'd pick up these while I was here.
Okay. You like bebop?
Well, something new. I'm always interested in new types of music, even if I don't always like them. Here. Take it out of this. It's all right, isn't it?
Bumpers and hubcaps, radiator grills and ornaments, bullseye seal beam headlights, ignition systems, spark plugs, batteries, fuel pumps, windshield wipers, instruments and gauges, wire and battery cable, and many more. So remember, from bumper to tail light, you're always right with Autolite.
Thank you.
product and its 96,000 dealers everywhere present Suspense.
Okay, Marty, it's 75 cents.
Man, that's a real gone platter.
Marty! Joe!
Eat it, Joe!
Oh, you're cool.
Eat it, Joe!
Take it from me, man. Isn't that great?
Guess where I was, Marty? Yes, yes! Down to Box City in that dumb kid. Oh, man, is he crazy? He nearly killed me.
Oh, that band is real crazy. I'm going down there now and talk to Bob.
Now you're with me.
Hey, wait a minute.
Change.
Take you later, Smarty Marty.
You know, I still can't figure out what you guys are saying.
Oh, it's easier once you get that rhythm.
I think I'll take a walk down the street and get my hair cut.
Okay, Mr. Brockman. Say, I've been thinking, Mr. Brockman. Did you really mean what you said the other day about the shop?
Why, yes. Yes, indeed, I did, Fred. Yes, indeed. I feel sure that this work is going to be too hard for me soon, and you're just the boy to carry on.
Well, I haven't got much saved yet, Mr. Brockman, but if you let me sign a note, I'll pay you just as soon as I can.
Well, now, we won't worry about that. I'm sure that we'll be able to figure out something, Fred. Now, you're a good boy, Freddy, a good boy.
May I help you?
How do you do?
Classical, isn't it?
I beg your pardon?
It's a game I play, trying to guess the kind of music a customer wants before he tells me. You see, we call ourselves a bebop alley, but we've got classics here, too. Mozart, Bach, Beethoven.
I see, you're quite correct in the way I am very fond of all those composers, but I don't want any records just now. Oh, that is, well, I do in a way, but what I wanted to ask you now is this your place?
No, this place belongs to Mr. Brockman. I just work here.
Oh.
I didn't want us to sell him, though. Mr. Brockman, he's really the boss, but he sort of takes it easy.
I see. Is he with new types of music, even if I don't always like them? Here. Take it out of this. It's all right, isn't it? You will come tonight, won't you?
I don't know, mister.
You've got to help me. It's desperately important. You've got to help me. Promise you'll come. Griffin Hotel, room 317. I need your help. I'll be expecting you as soon as you can get away. And don't say a word to anybody. Please.
Excuse me.
Hey, Joe, turn down that volume, will you? Hey, mister. Mister.
Ready, boy, wait a minute.
I won't latch onto this now. Fuck it. Now, look, here's the bit. I'm going to cut out, but I'll be back later. Maybe you can go out and brew up.
Okay.
You with me, man?
Yeah.
I'll dig you later.
He had too many people waiting down there, and I didn't get my hair cut.
Well, that's too bad, Mr. Brockman.
No, one day more or less don't matter. That'll just go 1/32nd of an inch longer. I'm lucky to have any left at all. What's the matter? Something worrying you?
Mr. Brockman, you're a man of experience. If a stranger asks you for help, do you think you ought to help him?
Well, that depends on the person himself, Freddy.
Well, will you be needing me for a while?
No, but it's past your quitting time anyway, isn't it?
Yes, but I'll be back. I told Joe I'd go out and get a couple of beers.
I think you ought to get some sleep. I'll tell Joe to wait if he comes back.
Okay, thanks.
Now, take care of yourself, Freddy. Be careful.
I will, Mr. Brockman. Good night.
Good night.
Evening. Hi. Hey! Where are you going?
317.
Mr. Evans?
Yes, Mr. Evans.
Come here. He expecting you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Say, what's he like?
Why don't you ask him?
Okay.
You sure may.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night.
Is Mr. Evans in there?
What do you want?
Mr. Evans is expecting me. Is he in there? I'm from the music store.
No. Who told you to come?
Mr. Evans did. He said it was important.